Hi friends, Cassandra here. Because I keep both a working pantry and long-term storage, this grocery haul goes beyond the basics and shows you how I'm able to easily purchase fresh food items and use techniques like dehydration, canning, and easy fermentation to preserve the shelf life of these items into the next 6 to 12 months. We're already starting to see aluminum can shortages, and that's unfortunate, but it also reveals how learning how to dehydrate, can, and ferment can and will give you a competitive edge at the grocery store now and in the coming months. I would estimate that about 60% of this haul is comprised of items that would otherwise be marked as perishable items. But as I give you a tour of everything I've bought, I'm also going to include tons of footage showing you how I'm using these three techniques to preserve the shelf life of my fresh foods. If this is your first time stopping by my channel, hi, I'm Cassandra, and I describe myself as a woman that has her feet on both sides of the grass. I live in a townhome in a city and work full-time outside of my home, but both my husband and I are homestead dreamers. This channel documents our countdown to our country escape, which we're hoping will happen in the next 4 years. But until then, you'll catch me digging my hands in the dirt or dough somewhere between my kitchen and garden, turning our 1/8 acre townhome into an urban homestead. So if you're interested in this type of content, please consider subscribing to my channel and giving this video a thumbs up. Finally, please speak to me in the comments section. Myself and others would love to hear any tips or suggestions or recommendations that you have in the comments section below. All right, let's jump into the haul. While they're abundant and in season, I'm going to actually can the 2 pounds that I picked up today. Canning mushrooms is super easy. My last Aldi haul, I picked up some French onion soup packet seasoning, which I'll use as a broth to can them in, and I'll have them in my pantry for the next couple of months. I only have a few jars left from what I canned last year, so I definitely want to can some more for this upcoming year. And as I shared, it is super easy, and home canned mushrooms retain their texture and have a superior flavor profile than commercially canned mushrooms. So I went ahead and I picked these up. So I also grabbed 2 bags of lemons, and similar to the mushrooms, while these are reasonably priced because they're in season, I wanted to go ahead to grab some to preserve. I enjoy slicing and dehydrating lemon for use in my hot tea during the cooler months and making preserved lemons. So these are also going into my long-term food storage. If you also follow my weekly garden tours, you'll know that my kale did wonderful this season, but kale is best as a full season crop. And while I plan to plant more kale since I have a small backyard, I went ahead and grabbed some extra kale to go ahead and dehydrate and then pulse into a powder to add to smoothies, spaghetti sauces, salads, and even as a garnish. Now I create my own powdered green mix and throw it into casseroles and soups, and to beef up my overall vitamin intake, especially during this season that we're in, where the focus is everyone is doing everything they can to build up their immunity. So after I dehydrate this kale, I'm going to seal it into an airtight container, and it's just nice to know that I have an abundance of kale on hand. Let's move back over to the nuts, and I grabbed a 2 pound bag of walnuts. My bulk nut inventory, it isn't the best to be honest, because nuts are not cheap, but I wanted to start somewhere. I already have pepitas that I grabbed at Aldi just last week, and now I have this bag of walnuts. Pine nut prices are through the roof this year, so I'll slowly build up my nut inventory. These are great for salads, and oh my goodness, have you ever heard of walnut crusted chicken breasts? Oh, so good. Basically, the breadcrumbs are a finely pulsed walnut, and it's fried, and it's so good. It's definitely kind of like a weekday treat dinner, but it's so worth it. Grab some avocados, again for the same reason, while they are reasonably priced and in season. And I love to just snack on these. I use them as an ingredient for my hair. I try to do all natural hair care. And oh, avocado toast, any time of the year, but especially while they're reasonably priced, is just such a treat. Comment below how you like your avocado toast. I love my avocado toast with like a chunky avocado mash. I'll throw in a little bit of lime juice, salt, pepper,
a little bit of crunchy, crispy bacon, and then an over easy runny egg. Oh, I love my runny yolks. My husband's like, oh, that's gross. But yes, that's how I mostly enjoy my avocados. Are also great, as you guys know, probably in smoothies. But yeah, I went ahead and just grabbed some avocados. Next up, we have garlic, and I mean, almost every meal in my house starts with a cast iron skillet, oil, diced garlic, diced onion, or both. but I cheated this time, y'all, and I did go ahead. This is the first time I've got it, and I grabbed some peeled garlic because I am putting up a lot of fermented garlic. I've done plain fermented garlic, honey infused garlic, and an herb infused garlic. And I want to continue to build up my inventory as I plant my own garlic later on this fall. Fermented garlic is a powerful food for health that a lot of people just simply overlook. It's a natural antibiotic, meaning that it suppresses bacteria. It's an immune stimulant, it's anti-inflammatory. And when you ferment it, the potency of that bite that garlic has, y'all, it seriously tremendously subsides into something that is so mild that you can actually eat a clove of it. Like, you can literally just pop it in your mouth. I was like, no way at first too, but now I do it once a day and it's just not a thing. I'm not gagging, my mouth isn't on fire. It's very doable. So this will allow me to just go ahead and jumpstart adding to my fermented garlic inventory. I did go ahead and also add some grapes because I just love grapes. I eat these like candy. This is a 3-pound container. And to be honest, y'all, this will probably, I mean, I can probably go through this in the next 2 days. I just, oh, I love grapes, especially red grapes. They're so sweet. They're so good. All right, so this is not a fancy item, but it completely is necessary. Our main trash can is the kitchen trash can. And so I wanted to make sure that our stockpile is really good. And while we're not generating as much trash as we were at the beginning of quarantine, trash bags, I don't know, at least in my house, they're kind of like toilet paper. You just, you don't want to be without them. Next up is tuna fish, and I love my shelf-stable meats. And I'm not canning my own tuna just yet. I have eaten through several cases of our current inventory just because it's a quick work-at-home lunch option that I pair with kale for my garden and other salad toppings that I have growing, like green onion and tomatoes and squash. So I wanted to replace the stock that we've gone ahead and eaten through. Just last month, I started fermenting my own cabbage and making sauerkraut. And when I really think about ways that I can boost my overall immunity this year, there are so many people that think like, oh, I'm gonna rush out and buy vitamins. And I have nothing against vitamins, y'all, at all. But I also think that it's best to go to the actual food source. And so cabbage, fermented cabbage especially, and even more so than the green cabbage, you wanna get the purple cabbage, but my BJ's didn't have any, although I think they do carry it, I've seen it there. But it has a higher vitamin C quantity than even your kind of shelf stable vitamins. And so for that reason, it's great for your overall immunity, excellent source of probiotics. It's a rich source in iron, and there are so many other trace elements that when they're fermented are exacerbated. So when we think about ways that we can increase our overall health, your best bet is to do that through food. So about one head of cabbage makes 1 quart. And so I want to go ahead, and again, I will be growing cabbage this fall. Hopefully I'll have about 8 to 10 heads of cabbage come in. So I don't need to go too crazy, but I do want to kind of perfect my sauerkraut recipe. And while I am doing that in preparation for what I'm growing, I want to experiment on store-bought cabbage. All right, so now we're gonna move over to medicines. They are back in stock at a variety of stores. And okay, friends, so let me kind of be clear. I am a budding, self-taught kind of herbalist that definitely believes in homeopathic medicine and herbal remedies. And I actively make my own tinctures with the herbs that I grow in my garden. However, I am neither 100% herbal remedies nor against Western medicine. So yes, I want to make sure that my stock of cold medicines alongside my own remedies are definitely full this season and, you know, always. I already have cold and flu medicines, but I'm running low on aspirin And I know that the alternative to this aspirin is actually Feverfew, and I definitely have that on hand. But again, I honestly do both. And I also wanted to grab some of the non-liquid form of the nighttime and daytime cold and flu medications before the anticipated run on these medicines happen. So we're gonna move on over to the carrot, and you guessed it, I'm gonna be fermenting these carrots. And if you haven't fermented carrots, definitely give them a try. They have that traditional carrot flavor that most people enjoy, with the addition of a salty, tangy, slightly sour kick, again, depending on how long you let it ferment. And you can also give them a more classic kind of like pickle flavor by adding pickling spices and garlic and onion and dill. Fermented carrots are super easy to make with just a mason jar, and they're another easy source of probiotics and natural vitamins. All right, y'all, so I've got some pink Himalayan salt, and to be honest, I finally made the switch, y'all. I know that pink Himalayan salt has loads of benefits like potassium and magnesium, and it just helps you to get the most out of what your body needs for sodium, and it kind of counters some of the negative effects of salt. I'm starting to get towards the lower stock of my white table salt, and so I figured, hey, now's a good time as ever to make this switch. And I really like that the container also has a grinder, so I have the option of using chunky and a finer texture of salt for my cooking options. All right, y'all, so next up, I grabbed this 10-pound bag, there you are, of russet potatoes. And I love to slice and dehydrate potatoes. Essentially, I make my own scalloped potatoes. It's super cheap. And when you realize just how overpriced scalloped potatoes, the ones that you buy in the box, are, and how easy it is to make your own, like, you'll probably be like me just to never go back. Because all you're getting are dehydrated potatoes and powdered cheese. I still have to add like milk and butter, and then maybe if you're like adding something else, like a meat or vegetables, to kind of round out that meal. Once you go ahead and dehydrate your sliced potatoes, they also easily rehydrate, meaning that you can make your own mashed potatoes. I often then add my own dehydrated cheeses that I get from the Amish market. Sometimes I'll add freshly cooked bacon or ground beef to make a scalloped potato casserole. But yeah, these potatoes will be with me well into the fall and winter. And again, these are just pretty much buffering up an existing inventory that I already have on hand. Goes for the sweet potatoes. However, I do enjoy my sweet potatoes fresh. I love a good sweet potato casserole any time of the year. You've seen in my hauls that sometimes I just get on like a marshmallow kick. So I have been making Rice Krispie treats, and what I'll do to make them healthier is add in different nuts to them. But then I also love adding mushrooms on top of my sweet potato casserole. Oh, it's so delicious. So you definitely have to make sure that the mushrooms are kind of like crusty and crunchy. I like them to be slightly kind of boiled. Plus, sweet potatoes are just super, super healthy for you. So I don't add lots of sugar, as long as I have like a bit of cinnamon in them to complement the natural sweetness that's already in the sweet potatoes, I am good to go. But these store really well, and I love sweet potatoes, y'all. So next up are our onions. I grabbed two bags. One will be for immediate use over the next, this might last me a month, because maybe 2 weeks. Because as I mentioned earlier, every meal in my home starts with onion or garlic. And then the other will be, as you probably already guessed it, for the dehydrator. And I mean, it's a no-brainer for me. I can easily create my own onion powder and then rehydrate sliced onions for soups, or even make pickled onions. And so, yeah, I want to go ahead and grab some extra onions. Okay, y'all, here in the back, I have some green beans. And this is my first year growing green beans in my garden. And I've gotten used to just eating green beans every single week. Now, I am going to grow some more of these in my garden as it turns from the summer to the fall garden, because green beans add nitrogen to your soil. They're mostly for me to go ahead and eat now, but I may pickle a few. Actually, probably not. I did go ahead and grab some more laundry detergent. This is a 196 fluid ounce container. I have been using the BJ's detergent for several years now, and it's excellent. This was, I believe, either $12.99 or $13.99 at my BJ's. It's a great value. I love the ability just to be able to put this on top of my washer machine, and you kind of turn it on the opposite side, and it has this pour spout, which I can then pour the liquid right into my washer. Again, competitively priced. My clothes come out smelling wonderful. I don't have any allergies. My husband doesn't, and so we don't have to worry about that. Although they do have a hypoallergenic brand of this as well. And I mean, detergent can be really expensive. I haven't found just yet a homemade laundry detergent that I really like. And so until I do, the Berkley Jensen brand is definitely what we enjoy. It does a great job at removing the stains, and again, it's cost effective. Now that we're home, I feel like there's just a lot more laundry that's being generated. And so I've gone ahead and used up, I keep about two or three of these in my inventory, and I'm down to two. So again, this is just replacing what I already have on hand. Right, y'all, so during the initial part of the pandemic, it was actually really hard to get your hands on pet food. And I was lucky that I already had an extra inventory of my French Bulldog's food. But when I had gone to BJ's shortly after things were starting to lock down, I was able to pick up a brand that he normally doesn't eat, but this is competitively priced. So for 24 pounds, this bag was $25. The food we normally get him is also a 24 pound bag, but it's almost $40. He is a French Bulldog, and they're known for having very sensitive stomachs. And so before this whole pandemic thing, we were just always very brand loyal with what he ate. And generally speaking, we will continue to be, but Thor, my Frenchie, really enjoyed this brand of dog food. And I just always want to make sure that we have something on hand. And what I'll do is I can start to mix it with what he normally eats. But this did not upset his stomach at all. And I mean, that's super rare because he's a really picky eater. Y'all, I love my dog. So I know for some of y'all that aren't dog people, you're like, oh my goodness, how is your dog a picky eater? So I did go ahead and just pick up an extra bag of this just because he really enjoyed it. It didn't upset his stomach. And I mean, this is almost half of what we normally pay for his stuff. And you know, if something happens again and there's another flare up, or just for me, thinking about my overall inventory and wanting to keep on hand, if you have your pets, you've got to think about their needs too. I'm gonna go ahead and sneak back over here. I almost forgot to talk about the coffee. BJ's coffee is such a value. I went ahead and got the classic roast ground coffee. This is a really good flavor profile. It is full body. It's a mix between a medium and a dark flavor profile. This coffee is just $12.99 for 40 fluid ounces. That's about 2.5 pounds. You cannot beat that. Absolutely love it. I already have their breakfast blend, which I really enjoy, downstairs, but I wanted to go ahead. I'm gonna have some of my family up over the next couple of months, and we'll be going through coffee in the morning. So I wanted to go ahead and add to my existing inventory. And I love the Wesley Farms brand. It's just a really good cup of coffee in the morning. All right, y'all, so there are several reasons why I love getting my eggs at BJ's. So I am a worm farmer. Yes, again, if you're just watching my channel for my food hauls, that's so cool, and please continue to do so. But these hauls actually tie into my other content because A, I use worm castings in my garden, which are a superior fertilizer and soil amendment, and my worms love eggshells. And so I love being able to just order a large quantity of eggs. What I'll do is I'll put some fresh eggs aside to use as over easy eggs, but then I will whip up two or three eggs and place them in a snack size freezer bag and freeze them for later use. Y'all, if you haven't tried it, there's no discernible difference, and it's perfect to use for scrambled eggs or for recipes that just call for eggs in your baking. Plus, I can store 30 eggs in a gallon bag just on my freezer door. Y'all, that is what I call winning at life. Not pictured in the video, but it's something that I have. Oh my goodness, this is crazy. There's like a deer. Can you guys see the deer? Oh my goodness, there are like two of them there. Yeah? This is so crazy. Okay, let's get back to the vlog. Okay, so I went ahead and I also picked up
two of the 16 ounce things of water just to go ahead and add to my existing inventory. I have gone through some of it just because I do like to use these in my worm bin and in my fermented foods, but it's always just great to obviously have purified water on hand.
To see more grocery hauls and get prepper tips, please consider subscribing to my channel and giving this video a thumbs up. I'll talk to you soon. Take care. God bless.